Hello friends, today I'm going to share a story. It's all a matter of time. Lord Shiva is an extremely popular deity in Hindu religions. His gluttonousness, anger, exuberance have attracted devotees from all over the world since centuries. According to mythology, Shiv and his wife Parvati resides in the snow-capped mountains of the Himalayas. In all the stories pertaining to that era, Hindu gods have been portrayed as majestic beings, dwelling in ornate places, living luxurious lifestyle, surrounded by servants. But Lord Shiva's lifestyle was starkly different from the other gods. And it was this difference which one day attracted the attention of Narada, the eternal sage. Narada appeared at Shiva's abode in Himalayas. He met Parvati and his characteristic style. The saint began instigating her. Why don't you ask Shiva to build a beautiful palace for you? Why are you leading a life of hardship, residing in these freezing caves? When all other gods live in magnificent palaces and lead an opulent lifestyle, surrounded by servants and beautiful maids, then why should you be the sole exception and live such a difficult life? He said. Taken in by Narada's glib talk, Parvati immediately went to Shiva and requested him to have a palace built for her. Shiva said, I have no objection, but actually it is time that decides whether a person should stay and under what circumstances. And in accordance with time, we are at the right place. It is not wise to be influenced by one's ego and go against the will of time. Parvati replied, You are God. The entire world worship you and bows to your supremacy. Time cannot be greater than you. Shiva replied, No, dear, you are mistaken. God is actually the highest state of mind a person can reach, but ultimately he is just a human being. And whether it is human being or the moon, stars or anything else for that matter, ultimately all are governed by time. But Parvati was in no mood to relent. She insisted, I am not interested in all these talks about time. I need a palace, that's all. All I know is that if you decide to do something, time cannot create obstacles in your path. Unable to convince Parvati, Shiva acquiesced to her wish, and on her orders, the construction of magnificent palace commenced. Parvati was elated. In due course of time, the palace was almost ready. Workers were now giving a final touch to the palace, after which Shiva and Parvati would soon reside in this palatial home. But time apparently had another plans. For some unknown reason, craved pillar of the palace began crumbling and the beautiful decorated walls came crashing down, along with the intricately designed ceiling. Within no time, the palace had collapsed into a mass of rubble. Shiva was aware of the tragedy, so he remained in the palace. Parvati, however, was deeply shocked by this incident. Parvati stubbornly refused to believe that time was the sole reason behind the collapse of the palace. She was upset by the fact that construction work was commenced without taking into account the muhurat. Parvati had, in her haste to build a palace of her own, failed to realize that a muhurat too was just another form of time. But how could Shiva convince Parvati? When it was not the right time to build the palace, how could there be an auspicious hour to begin its construction? Despite being aware of this profound truth, Shiva decided to keep his own counsel. On Parvati's instructions, an auspicious hour was chosen, and once again construction work of the palace commenced. Finally, the day arrived when the palace was completed and ready to be occupied. Parvati was overjoyed, but this time she did not want to take any risk. She called a pandit to perform the puja. With the puja, it was time for the dakshina. According to custom, a Brahmin could demand anything as his dakshina and could not be refused. So when Parvati asked the Brahmin what he would want as his dakshina, he kept quiet for some time and then spoke. Leaving anything dumbstruck, he said, "I love this palace. This is what I would like as my dakshina." Parvati was so upset and could not believe what she had just heard. The plate of sweets she held in her hand slipped and crashed to the floor. In those days, it was unusual for a Brahmin to demand such gifts for his services, let alone an entire place. But this Brahmin was obviously different. Parvati felt hurt and dejected. Turning on her wheels, she immediately left the palace in a huff, leaving Shiva to fulfill the Brahmin's demand. Shiva, though aware of his eventually, could not bear to see his beloved wife looking distraught and unhappy. He attempted to reason with her and said in an affectionate tone, "I had already told you that everything is governed by time. No one gains anything by going against it. So let us stop dreaming for staying in a palace and resume our blissful life in these wonderful caves." Parvati obstinately refused to let go of her dreams. Instead, she said, "If time is truly responsible for these incidents, then why don't you go to tell time to change its stride? After all, who can ever disobey you?" Attempting to convince Parvati once again, Shiva explained, "Time determines its stride according to its own reason and arithmetic. It has never changed its stride to someone's command or to favor anyone. So it is futile to harbor such expectations." However, Parvati was adamant and refused to see reason. Her demand for a palatial home, Shiva had to once again give in to her wish. It was decided that once the palace was ready, Shiva would go to the time with an earnest request to change its stride in his favor so that he and Parvati could live in a palace without further mishaps. Once again, construction of the new palace began in full swing, and soon it was ready to be occupied. As decided, it was now time for Shiva to visit time and request it to alter its stride. Before leaving, he looked at Parvati lovingly and said, "My dear, as you had wished, I am now going to visit time with our request. But bear in mind, if time does not accede to our request, then we will set fire. I don't want your dream to be shattered once again. So if time does not accede to my request, I will perform the tanda. When you see me dance, take it as a sign that time has refused my request and set fire to the palace." Parvati quietly nobbed her head in agreement. Early the next morning, Shiva paid a visit to time. He appraised time of Parvati's desire to live in a palace and earnestly requested it to change its stride so that his wife could fulfill her dream. After listening to him in rapt attention, time replied, How can I ever turn your request down, my lord? I have just one condition though. If you perform your famous Tandav Nritya for me, I'll change my stride." Now what could Shiva do? He at once started performing his Tandav Nritya. When Parvati heard the beat of the Nritya, she thought that time had refused their request. With a heavy heart, she set the newly constructed palace on fire. So even though time had consented to change its stride, the event that ultimately occurred was precisely what was meant to occur in accordance with the stride of time. Moral of the story: there is no greater knowledge in human life than that of recognizing the importance of time. If a person begins to understand it, he can lead a life full of happiness and success. A person must understand that there is a right time for everything, and anyone who knows precisely what to forge ahead, step back, halt, move faster, work harder, or get some rest achieves phenomenal resources. success. A person desires and even his relentless effort that go against time do not lead to positive outcomes. Great people have experienced phenomenal success in their life only by following the tide of time. Therefore, if you want to achieve greatness in life, gain knowledge of time. Thank you.